Yeah, this is Coach Skip. It's Thursday, and we've got a great workout for you here at WildFire CrossFit. We're going to start with the warm-up. We got two rounds for quality, so really focus on good quality movements with all these exercises. We're going to start with a 10-second bar hang. So if you've got a bar to hang on to, just grab that bar, engage those shoulders, and just hang for a good 10 seconds, and then let go. If you don't have a bar to hang on to, just grab a couple of dumbbells or some heavy objects, water bottles, anything like that, and just hold on for that same 10-second time period, just to get those shoulders loosened up. Then we're gonna get into 10 bent over rows. You can use dumbbells, you can use a barbell, you can use any weighted object you've got. You're gonna hinge at the hips, engage those hamstrings, keep those shoulders back as you bring that bar right up to the chest and right down, and really get that full extension to really get those shoulders and upper body loosened up. Then we're gonna go into 10 alternating leg V-ups. So start flat on your back, arms overhead, and you're gonna bring your right arm to your left leg, and then your left arm to your right leg. And just back and forth, 5 times on each side for a total of 10. Then we're gonna go into 10 narrow squats. So put those feet together and really work on that range of motion and keeping that chest up. Don't just let that chest fold down towards the body. After the narrow squats, we're gonna go into sumo squats, so a little bit wider than your normal squat stance. Get those hips back, reach for the ground, keep that chest up, really engage those hips and get everything loosened up there. Final one is gonna be 10 reverse lunges. So you just step back and step right up, and just alternate legs each time. So go through that, good pace, get a sweat going, and get that body moving for the rest of the work we got today. Today for our strength, we've got some core strength for you. So we're gonna do some good core work and some alternative movements to get you moving. First, we're gonna do 1 minute at each station. At the end of all 5 stations, you're gonna go right back through for another minute of each for a total of 2 rounds of each exercise. The first one is gonna be the deck squat. On the deck squat, you're gonna have a small object in your hand, 10 to 20 pounds, doesn't need to be real heavy. You can use a dumbbell, a kettlebell, or any odd object around the house. You're rolling back on your shoulders, and then as you come up, you're gonna keep those feet together as you stand up in that squat position. That weight is just gonna provide some momentum to help you get up that standing position. So one more time, sit back, go all the way back, roll forward, and just stand up and out of it. After that, so you're gonna do that for a full minute. Then you're gonna go into 1 minute of Russian twist. Use that same object that you use for the deck squats. Make sure here in that Russian twist to make it more challenging, keep your feet off the ground, and really get that twisting motion, get that object all the way to the ground as you go back and forth to really work those obliques. If you need to put those heels down, just bring those heels up and rock back and forth as you bring those heels up to engage the core a little bit more through that movement. Then we're gonna go into L-sit hold. If you've got a couple of chairs, couple of benches that you can do this on, that'll be perfect. If you've got a pair of parallettes like this or a bar to hang from, we can do it from there as well. How that L-sit's gonna go is you're going to get into that position, legs straight out, core engaged, and really keep that core engaged the entire time. The more those feet drop, the more you're gonna leave that core out of it, and that's exactly what we're building up here. You can also do this where you do a bent knee hold, where you're just holding here, same thing, you're gonna keep that core engaged the entire time. If you have a bar to hang off of, you can also do the same L-sit hold from the bar, just getting right up and holding it in a position there, and that's really gonna engage that core. You can also do the same knee raise in that position where you just bring your knees up just above parallel and keep that core engaged the entire time. Then we've got a fun one for you, and this is the Copenhagen plank. For the first minute, you're gonna do one side, and for the second minute in the second round, you'll do the other side. Again, using a bench or a chair or any object that you can support this way, you're going to get in here and you're going to put one foot on top. You're going to put that elbow on the ground and you're just going to go up and hold that plank position right here, keeping that bottom leg off the ground. To make this a little bit easier, just scoot in. The more you've got that the weight that's supported closer to the body, the easier it's going to be. So if you need to make this a little bit less challenging, you're just going to scoot in so your knee or your thigh is on that bench holding in that plank position. The last one is going to be the windshield wiper. So you're going to hold that same object right over your chest and you're going all the way up and just back and forth here in that wiper fashion for a minute. On this one, the heavier the object, the better. The whole point is just to keep your chest and shoulders to the ground while you're engaging that core and getting your legs back and forth. For the workout today, we've got a 15-minute AMRAP where you're going to be doing 5 chest-to-bar pull-ups, 10 toes-to-bar, and 15 air squats. So on that chest-to-bar pull-up, you're going to grab onto that bar, and you're really going to grip that big pull-up so you get that chest actually coming in contact to the bar every single time. You can do that same kipping motion. You can do a butterfly motion. As long as that chest touches the bar, that is the prescribed version. Challenge yourself on this one. If you're not quite there with chest-to-bar pull-ups, but have your kipping pull-ups down, just get as high as you can and get as close as you can with every single rep. Then we're going into toes-to-bar. Use that same kipping motion to get those toes all the way to the bar. If you're not quite there, what I'd rather you focus on today more than anything else is keeping those legs straight in that kipping motion, even if you're not quite in getting all the way up to the top, just right there, or do that knee raise where you bring your knees up to your chest in that same kipping motion. After your 5 chest-to-bar pull-ups and 10 toes-to-bar, you're going to do 15 air squats. Really work on speed and range of motion on those air squats. Go as many rounds as possible in 15 minutes and really challenge your gymnastic skills with this one. For the body weight or lightweight version, you're going to do the same 15-minute AMRAP. If you don't have a pull-up bar for your chest-to-bar pull-ups, you're going to do that bent-over row, bringing that bar right up to your chest, full extension as you bring it all the way back down. If you're doing just a body weight version of this one, you're going to do what's called a plyo push-up, where you go all the way down, touching that chest to the deck, and then explode at the top, bring those hands off the ground with every rep. For the toes-to-bar, if you don't have your pull-up bar, you're going to go a V-up, where you just go down, hinge at the hips, bring your toes and your fingers together, and right up and down, work that same kipping motion, and then you're gonna finish it with the same 15 air squats. So the body weight or lightweight version is gonna be the same 15-minute AMRAP, either 5 bent over rows or 5 plyo push-ups, 10 toes to bar or V-ups, and then 15 air squats. Have fun, get gymnastics on this one, and we'll see you soon back at Wildfire CrossFit.